Today we will be talking about the water cycle. This covers 4.8b of the TEKS. Describe and illustrate the continuous movement of water above and on the surface of the Earth through the water cycle, and explain the role of the sun as a major source of energy in this process. There are three main parts to the water cycle: evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. The first part of the cycle we will talk about is evaporation. Evaporation occurs when water warms and changes to water vapor. In our natural environment, the sun warms our groundwater, causing it to evaporate.
Go.
The next part of the water cycle that I want to talk to you about is evaporation. Evaporation occurs when the sun heats up the ground, and the moisture that's on the ground goes from a liquid to a gas, and that gas is called water vapor. In this example, the hot plate represents the sun, and the beaker, and the water in the beaker represents the water that's on the ground. The sun warming up all the water that's on the ground, therefore turning it into a gas, and this is steam, or water vapor. And that is evaporation. Condensation is the next part of the cycle we will talk about. Condensation occurs when water vapor cools and turns back into water droplets. This is when clouds are formed. The water on the outside of this can is a form of condensation. Okay, the last part of the water cycle that we're going to talk about is condensation. Condensation occurs when the water vapor goes up into the sky and it's cooler up there, so that gas turns back into a liquid. Therefore, it condenses together, forming condensation, which turns into clouds. We place the mirror on top of the beaker and we leave it there for a little while. I think that's good. When we lift the mirror up, you see that the water vapor, the steam, has turned back into a liquid before causing condensation. Precipitation, the last part of the water cycle. Precipitation can be rain, snow, sleet, or hail. It falls from the clouds to the earth. The clouds cannot hold any more moisture, so it precipitates. Rainwater is an example of precipitation. What happens in precipitation is a cloud is formed through water molecules that has been evaporated from the ground. Eventually, the cloud becomes so full of moisture that it starts to fall to the ground. This sponge here represents a cloud, and the water that just leaked down to the bucket shows exactly what happens when the cloud gets too full. Eventually, that cloud will lose all its moisture, disappearing, and the process will start over again, where the water will evaporate into the atmosphere, forming clouds, filling up with moisture, and eventually raining again. And that is precipitation. If water didn't naturally recycle itself, then we would run out of clean water in a very short period of time. Without water, we would all die. Here to help me explain the water cycle is Ms. Holbrook's fourth grade class. Go.
Water travels in a